Hi, hi buddies, welcome back to my channel. It's your pepper girl, as you already know, Oshine Adeola. How are you guys doing? If you're Yoruba, Shewa Dada, Ekaro, Ekason, Ekale. So on today's tutorial, I'm going to be showing you guys how to bead your fabric either on your skinnet, organza, dullface, duchess, and any other fabric of your choice. So just stay tuned as we work together, okay? Welcome back, buddies. So on this tutorial, like I said earlier, this is a beading tutorial, and I feel like majority of our fashion designers these days, they make mistakes with, you know, the detailing of beading. Like, I already made this video, I already beaded this already, but you know, I'm going to show you how to bead them without making it look disorganized. It has to be neat, it has to be well beaded, it has to be well detailed. Do you understand? These are like the very essential things you have to do when you're beading, and you need some very important equipment also when you're beading, because this equipment, without them, trust me, your stitching and your beading and every other thing will look so disorganized. Okay, I don't know if I'm making sense, but that's it. So here we go. Your first essential that you need is going to be your lighter. Lighter is like very important, especially for me. I use lighter to like do finishing works for my projects. Okay, the next one should be your rhinestone. It doesn't have to be rhinestone, it could be beads, it could be anything that your needle can just pass through it, so far it suits the style and the fabric you've chosen. Okay, so rhinestone is also very important. Like I said, also, it doesn't have to be a rhinestone, it could be beads. Like the other video, or the black dress you saw, everything was beaded, and you know, I had like some rhinestone patches on it. Okay, so that's very, very important. The next one is your needle. Your needle is very, very important. You also need to know that there are different types of needle that you need to use, but where you can get this particular needle is like beading stores. But I think like most of the people that they sell like fabric appliques, I think they sell them also. So this particular needle is like very, very tiny. I'm going to put the details on the screen, okay? And this is also a fishing line that is also very important. Like I said earlier, majority of our fashion designers, they make mistakes while doing this work, okay? So this is part of the mistakes. Some people use threads and it's not even perfect for beading a fabric, okay? It looks so tacky and disorganized. So fishing line is very, very important, and a very tiny fishing line to be precise. So fishing line is very, very important when you're doing your project. You shouldn't use any thread. All you need is a fishing line. The aim of this fishing line is to make it look neat and well organized and not to look tacky. So what I'm doing next is to pass through the rhinestone or the bead, any of your choice, into the fabric. And please, when you're passing through your beads, you need to pay attention to the measurement. The measurement is very, very important. You don't need to pass through an half inch away. As you can see, the distance between the first bead and the second bead should be 3-4 away from each other. It shouldn't be up to half inch when you're making this kind of clothes. Like the black dress I made, the distance was just like 1-4 away from each other. So it depends on what you want and how you want it to look like. But the highest distance I would advise you to do should be 3-4. It shouldn't even be up to an half inch, okay? So that makes your work really nice, trust me. If you can even like bead closer to each bead, do you understand? It makes your work look neat and well elegant. Like, it just gives the telling, it just gives like everything. When you call a particular price for your client, trust me, they'll buy it. Just do it like that. I'm a proud Nigerian, and trust me, Nigeria fashion designers, they've been doing so well when it comes to like detailings. I mean, like people from outside the country, like they even come to like, you know, tutor and even lecture from us. Like, we teach them how to do every. You should know, like, we self, we know they carry last, we self they try. So I'm a proud Nigerian, if you don't know. But trust me, when you do all these details that I've introduced to you, without skipping any of the tutorial video, and trust me, you definitely get your perfect beading. Fashion has always been like the most very important thing since our forefathers. I mean, so if you have the mindset of learning how to become a fashion designer, please don't allow anybody deceive you. Just take your time and learn, okay? Fashion is not a quick do or die affair. You just have to just take your time and make sure that you're not a lazy person. You can get every tutorial that you watch on YouTube without going to any fashion school. Just take your time. Spend more than a year on YouTube. Spend 6 months on YouTube. Trust me, you will know how to sew. Beginner's class, advanced classes, any one of your choice. We have everything here on YouTube. It doesn't have to be my YouTube channel that you have to watch. You can watch some other YouTube channels if you are a beginner and you don't have like suitable fee to go for a physical tutorial. You can learn that on YouTube. But at the same time, some people can be very good at, you know, learning physically than learning on YouTube. Then if you are very capable of the fee, then you can go and learn physical tutorials, okay? So thank you guys for watching this tutorial, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial the way I enjoyed filming and making voiceover. You already know what to do. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, turn on your notification buttons for next content, okay? Love you buddies. Bye.